change order number four?
I'll move to accept change order number, special change order number four.
I'll second that. And discussion, so Aaron?
Yes.
Just so that Mike, both Mike and I are clear on this, change exclusive of price location will be the time the road division can re- construct its finished structure upgrade. And we're saying by this change order that will be an additional 7 days or 5 working days, which takes next Friday, I believe, is that?
Correct.
That's correct, okay.
Original contract had it in this past Friday, yesterday.
Yeah.
So.
Well, it's a change order.
Prior to change.
Yeah, prior to.
Oh, yeah, right, yes.
And now we're extending it one more week.
Yes.
Okay, and at the moment, there's no, we're not approving any change in contract.
Right, and actually, we don't have, so I talked internally about how to handle that, and there's really no way to say, well, we reserve the right, either are you going to do it or you're not going to do it. And we looked at, but I had some conversations with Jim Parker about this, and if you look at the time that they were slowed down at Lower Mill, it's probably a few days at least with those 30, 40 utilities that we didn't know about. Yeah, it was unbelievable. Every 2 feet, you know, when you, and I had those old mill buildings, there was an array of pipes underground. And then at least a few days on Pine Street with the additional water. And Jeff did, when we were at the pre-bid conference, Jeff clearly said it dried up to a trickle in the summer, which maybe some years it does, but this year it certainly didn't. And Jeff said, well, I based all my water diversion approach based on that understanding. So I talked to Jim after this, and we're going to execute this change order. We're not going to reserve the right to liquidate the images or assess them, but we're also not going to give you any compensation for the time that you were slowed down at Lower Mill and this water diversion. So it's a no-cost change order for any of this.
Mm-hmm.
So there's, he can't come back and say, well, I took an extra 2 days, it's, you know, a delay claim, basically foreload the right for those items in this change order.
Okay, and do you wait, do you get the culvert for it?
All but 6 feet, so the water is flowing through it. I have 6 more feet and the head wall will install on Monday, which should be pretty straightforward. And will be no issues, I don't see, with getting substantial completion by Friday.
So the bulk of the worry about the water diversion and all those sorts of things, is that kind of what you said?
Yes. I just stopped on the way here and the water's flowing through, it's stable. They got to set up, you know, stand back again to be water to be able to put that last section of pipe and head wall in, but that's.
And the road closures is back to what it was originally, doesn't include the terrace, but, you know.
It shouldn't. I didn't come in from that side. I came in from the Willie side, but I would imagine there's, I can check on that.
Check on that. Back a little bit.
Michael, do you have any questions?
No, it looks like we're at clear weather this week, right? So it should be separate sale.
Okay, well, I'm ready to call a question. All those in favor of granting this of change order number four to the partner and daughter's contract, say aye.
Aye.
I don't know. Let me check. No, just one.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. I don't know if they're calling her, she's calling in, we can check if she sent it in, you know. All right.
Well, the, meeting.
Yes, she just texted me before I did, I was coming here, and she said, very sleepy, even by phone, I won't be up to. Does she not want?
Her, right, but I would tell her.
Yeah, just, well.
She wants.
I sent her everything. Can I have a little, I don't wanna.
She's doing all right, though?
Yes. Yes. Really want me to know what to do, Mike?
What?
You want me to take my note?
Sorry, my back went out, but it's too. It's strong.
Yes, it's all been arranged.
So this is the, this is a new board.
Yes, but it's not hooked up, so we're not rejecting.
Yeah, well, this is it.
Yeah, hopefully we can bring it up.
Yeah.
It's on, you know, it's on the.
It's over. Just, well, yeah.
So, it's a little low.
I don't know, yes, you can, I'm not gonna do it, though.
Right, so.
We would want two people to take time to, and be honest with you.
I would ask that Dick Porter, does it?
Huh?
Dick Porter, is he gonna?
He worked with Richard to get it in place, which is great, just, yeah.
Well, I'm just, he has experience with moving them, I would ask him, but it looked like it was.
Yeah, it looks like.
Screw the background, just can't get on top. All right.
Okay, so. Yes, and what I do have from here is.
I saw Mark, right.
Do you want the lights on?
Yeah, I do. Do you mind turning it off, or can you still see if you broadcast with it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Actually, it's better with it off. Yeah, it's better. Okay, so, you know, this is still, there's a lot of unknowns, a lot of things that we're not sure of, but, you know, we need to jump in. And there are a lot of knowns, I think, I always like to start to, you know, when you're thinking about this, when I build it from the bottom up. But here's the big picture. So, we've got, right now, operating budget, roughly this, $8-9 million. This is our long-term loan payment, which is still not completely resolved, because we have to close them, we went to the main loan. So, but it has an approximate. This is what I'm putting in as a request of capital improvement reserve fund, it was roughly what we had managed or planned for this year. This is our annual road maintenance, and I'll have a little more to say about this. But it's in the operating budget, the warrant article is relevant, this is total. Right now, there's $75,000 in the operating budget, so I took it out because it's here, right, it's in this one.
Right.
So, and there's an NHDOT supplement, which is brand spanking, so I've got that.
So line five, you're incorporating the line two at the top, does that mean?
Just $75,000.
The $75,000.
So we have to keep $225,000.
Sure.
So I guess it's total of, the grant total of like 2.5, or 2.2 and 2.3. So right now, the increase in expenditures over the prior year is close to 3. Personally, I'd like to get it closer to 2. Well, this is, these are just notes for me, guys.
So, line 2 incorporates assumptions on insurance increases, that's what it's like.
We'll see some of the assumptions that I've made as we go through, but I'd like to start with, here's where we are right now, with a lot of still unresolved issues.
Yep.
So 2.8%. The other thing to look at is, well, the overall, we'll come back to revenue, the overall tax impact.
Yep.
So based on that, the total appropriation, capital, long-term financing, and our anticipated revenue that I've worked on, you know, we're looking at, you know, this, we don't know what the, I don't know what the final figure of damage one is. So we're looking at an increase of about 12.5%. No, that's what I think. Yeah, I wouldn't count on that.
No, no.
So, but that's where we are. So even though this is up, you know, right now we're still looking at that kind of a projection. So it's, you know, partly the grant that we're going to get from Darrow and all that kind of stuff. All right, so now I think, now we've got this sort of kind of big picture, I'd like to look at the expense appropriation. And I guess we do action by action. So one thing you'll see everywhere is all the election dependent lines have multiplier of 3. We have one election line over here, we've got 3 elections. So that's true for the moderator, the checklist, the budget, the checklist. Okay. Finance and administration is up because last year the increase in hours only took place in April. So now we have a full year. Now we have a full year. So we have 9 months. This fiscal year we've got 5 options. There's no change right now then in clerical support. And it is all based on a 2% across the board with a 3% for the police. 2% for everybody else, 3% for the police.
And how would that define the difference?
Market, you know, as you know, based on what even 2 years ago that chart showed from the district. Budget committee secretary, 2%. Payroll tax is a simple calculation. The reason it's down is because much of Caroline's is under the retirement system.
Okay.
Whereas last year, that's for 3 months, the full payroll tax.
Okay.
So, and therefore the retirement is up. So, life and disability health. In this model, we've got them collected, all collected, and down in personnel administration. So that zeroes out each one.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm thinking it's an argument, too, to do the same thing for employee safety. It covers all employees in training, and it covers most, at least if I have their own. So we do have an objection. We move those 2 lines down to that. All right, then I'll take care of that. Budget and communications is the same. Conference and dues is the same. Mileage the same, our like mine is with Caroline, she's good with that. Office equipment we've increased, yes?
No, I have a question.
Office equipment we've increased the 5 years to incorporate leasing a copier at $112 a month that will be fully networked. We reduced the office equipment repairs by that $500, so that these 2 lines are a wash. Printing and copying, we've increased by 500. This incorporates any of our own copy that we need and printing we need, as well as the town report. And I still got a review on it because I'd like to talk to our town clerk, and I'd like the board to think about maybe printing a smaller annual report, having everything available online, and printing a smaller annual report.
We need to review the statutes and see what's required in the town
report. Exactly. And the town clerk is aware what those are as well. Okay. Telephone, no change. Supplies, no change. Postage, no change. IT has an increase. We can go to the detail line. So Google Apps, we basically have 20 users, which is support the Tom or any other computer.
20 users is still.
We're right now using either 15 or 16.
Okay, so we have room.
Yeah, there's a request from the fire department to
right.
come on board,
yeah.
So that will incorporate
perfect.
Them.
Perfect.
that's where that $9,800 comes from. Professional services, so let's take a look at that. All right, well, we have a training welfare, so we've got that. Maybe we'll finish it this year, we'll get it set this year. Right now, we've got there. We've completed the, much of the boundary work is over. We don't have a completed memorandum of agreement. We've got a winter one. So I think we need one that encompasses road maintenance in general, all those sorts of things. And a perambulation, if there are any, I think there's some boundaries that they want to put in there.
Yes.
So it's the MOA and any associated entities.
Right.
Yes, yes. Or something that can be read by satellite or something. I don't know exactly what they are, but I think Dover's working on a proposal with McEnany. But this will encompass all of those costs. Clients, we've got our standard favorites that we would like to take care of. One of which we tour started this year. Well, you know, there's a junkyard in the DES.
Oh.
Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Now you can. Yes. So that's why we need that's in there today. South Tower League, you know, we asked Steve at the beginning of this year to look at potentially renewing our South Tower League to increase revenue. So that's in there. This is incidental, just in case they want to catch up with the FERC hydro license, nothing as yet. And then general for all things that we're anticipating. If we want to do some planning on Sligo Road, there's 8,000 and then general engineering. So that's where this special services comes from. It is a decrease of 7,500 total what we were planning for. Well, we had bond council. We weren't sure. So bond council fees came out as well.
I'm thinking that we could burst the budget with compliance, but not off the budget. I'm not looking to spend more money. I'm just cautiously optimistic that we'll be able to survive with the legal amount that we have.
Okay.
So just, at least I know that we could go back and.
It's just right now to be correct. Yeah, the digital call 6.1% increase in the number.
Okay.
So the police and all of them. Reimbursable expenses. So we've got 3,000 for police, and this has to do with things that happen when they arrest people and they get them shelter fees and we get reimbursed, but bank fees.
Yeah.
Vehicle accidents, I upped this from last year. And bonds.
We're 10,000 capital reimbursement.
Yeah.
What?
I think we're too low. So this, and this 14,700 has revenue on the revenue side.
Right. Yeah.
So we have to tax on that. Short term interest payment, it's there. I don't know if it's. We likely won't use it this year because the way we brought the loan with Canadian Savings Bank, they get their short-term interest when we close the USDA. So it happens as part of that closing and the cost of the financial cost. So that's where we are. It's a decrease. You have to remember we've taken some things out and putting them somewhere in the personnel. We have a couple more things. Elections and registration, so the town clerk, we agreed to put forth whatever the town clerk decides, but right now we're using the ATV.
What it used to be.
The ATV.
It stopped for a while.
Yeah. Well, I think it's cleaner, and, as long as the town clerk doesn't want to come in and give us a figure. The election increases with the per election. As does the ballot clerk stages. And the taxes, of course, go up accordingly. I asked Kate to approximate what we might cost for programming printing ballots because we bear the cost of the programming for all Lunch is 23, 200 is number of lunch. And order. Fire for administration, tax, no change, director tax, 22% APU, payroll taxes. Audit, there was an increase in his cost this year, and so we decided, I'm recommending we increase it by 500, because you're not only budgeting for the standard audit, but also in case someone in a possible position is on.
Right.
We don't know what the costs are for our avatar, but this is the year the contract is up, and so I budgeted a 5% increase. Personnel administration. So this is health. I don't have it written down, but this is health with a 5% inflation. But no accommodation for
health insurance.
Yes, everybody's collected.
Right.
No accommodation for changes in coverage. So the single becomes a double, or the double becomes a family.
Right.
This just covers what is known today. So there's that exposure.
Mm-hmm.
I think I've taken some columns here. So this is collecting all life and disability.
Yep.
There's no inflation right now. It's small. I don't know whether it will go up. And this is unemployment. No inflation. We haven't heard. Workers' comp, I put a 9% increase. When we signed some kind of cap threshold with Primex, they said they're guaranteeing a rate increase that doesn't exceed 9%. So hopefully it will be 9, but yeah, this is the worst case scenario. This is one of the things we'll come back to if we get more paychecks. They usually encourage us to inflate it by 5%. Background checks, we had a lot because of counselors and stuff, so
yeah.
I think this is a better figure.
Mm-hmm.
Did you want to say something?
No, it's a realistic figure.
Dental benefits. We'll keep in there at 1 and termination lease payments. Again, you know, and if you look at our budget this year to see if there's any amount at the end, but it would be nice to clear out the sick leave days that we have.
Mm-hmm.
Point of it cleared out, we're there for time. So we're not carrying that. All right, planning and zoning. Planning though. 2% across the board here. No change in planning consultants. You can think about that to see if it's in sufficient hours and whether we can keep it as is. Zoning secretary, 2%. Payroll taxes. We obviously made a mistake last year, so the only reason that we increased it that much is because. Yeah, it was probably supposed to be 581.
I'm sure it probably was.
And something happened, so. Caroline recommended, or I asked, is there any reason to keep the advertising for zoning and planning separate?
Yeah.
No. So we've got them consolidated. This is the amount of both in this fiscal year, and it's the same amount going forward. It gets reimbursed. Janitor, 2%, payroll taxes, supplies, an increase of $100, probably based on usage at the time that I was putting this together. No change in sewer, no change in water, but I don't know why I'm concerned with these.
The water?
Yeah. So, I'm not sure. So, we don't know what the final cost of water. They haven't had an increase in many years, but. Heat, we're keeping it the same in town hall, we're recommending keeping it the same. And highway shed. The transfer station will have another decrease again must be based on what we, what I saw, but. Yeah, we can take a look at that, too. Transfer station, I gave it an increase only because of the compactor, but I, well, I was running one at a time, no, we didn't want, so.
I don't know.
There may be no impact, so we can, let me just, we'll revisit this. It's, you know, it's not the end of the world, $300, but. Electricity, the fire station, again, I'm sure there's a reason, they have an income or something. So maybe there's some efficiencies with, putting equipment that they, replacement, I don't really know. All right.
And a giant, air compressor on there.
Yeah, yeah, right, so, that could be why. Maintenance of town hall, so this is one where we really, like, made a mess of it this year. But going forward, we've got, we've talked about paying and repairing the courthouse. We've got mold remediation and a very serious contract, so at the moment, that seems to be covered by the $10,000.
Yeah.
So we can think about that going forward, but.
So because of the estimate that we got from the courthouse?
Yeah, $2,500.
Okay. That's for 2 years ago, or year ago?
Yeah, so we've got, so, well, that's the point, and we've got mold remediation, $3,500.
Yeah.
And very serious contract, or, you know, maybe, maybe another $2,500, so we're like $5,500. So I mean, I think there's, we can think about what it means, but we can get better, we'll get better numbers next time around, you know, let me do this, and this will prompt me to try and get some more detail, so we can, so I'm going to come up with a service contract that we're probably out of this. So repairs on the highway shape, we still want to include moving office. It's interesting to know the door is a carpenter, so.
I want to highlight this somehow.
Yeah.
We'll have a conversation with them when he's on board.
We had budgeted two, which was low, but Jody was saying we'll get people to do it for us, but.
I haven't seen that knock on the door, but we're going to ask it once, so. But, was it the, I don't remember the issue, I know there's mold, but.
Mold.
Is it from the trucks that, that are running, that come back after a storm, melt, is that what it is, or is it?
No, it's a pitch, drainage, or whatever the building.
Right, I get that, but so is it because the, is it for like weather, like rain or that, or is it that? Or is it because of, melt and snow from the trucks? I understand that it's pitch of the floor.
Yeah, I don't know, you can ask Jody. All right, I checked in with Mark, and he is requesting that we repairs and maintenance at 75 at the fire station. And he will talk to us about his plans. Transfer station, I still have a sort of review, but I think based on usage this year, actually. And we bought new stuff, and we did the improvement, but
right.
As far as repairing.
Long run.
Yeah. So, hydro plant, expected to be the same, water, hydro plant, again, we don't know, some sort of hydro plant, and they've seen its capacity for Berwick and hydro,
right.
Cemeteries, we haven't heard from them yet.
So Mark, at the post office, right, yeah, yesterday, cycle CMP stuff, and he says that doesn't anticipate any capital projects, but they would like to buy a laptop, so we could, or any computers on site to keep here, to replace the dinosaurs, and then, I thought it would make you happy, it certainly made him happy.
Well, we'll only need a conversation, depending on what informs the wrong description, obviously.
Yeah, well, that's what he's trying to figure out, I mean, it's not going to be.
But if he can use a Chromebook, that's fine.
Maybe.
Yeah. You know, you can access it from anywhere.
Right.
You know, there's five of them. So, all right, we'll talk about that. Insurance, so property liability insurance, we've got that 9% maximum every 6 months. regional association, I've got, I just inflated it, or this is FRPC and the municipal association. We usually get them, you know, over the next 4 to 6 weeks. We have, even after the vote, I do. All right, so here's what I did in the weekend, based on conversations we had before. So I kept the chief separate because it's a part-time position, but anyone wants to get it, that's the right thing to do. But all of the time salaries are now in one line, so that's the base. That's the, what their current base salary.
Right.
In fiscal 17. And then this is the 3% of this, includes the chief salary, 3% of all is 71 cents.
If you want from there.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, wrong, wrong. I did it across the board on the chief salary.
I got you, I see that.
As I'm reading this. So this amount is 3% of this.
Yes, I've run off.
Yeah, yes. This is overtime, which is just a note that we mostly get it. Corporate witness, these are the same, and these are, I pulled right from, spreadsheet. So we could ask him when he thought it would be any, drop in some kind of salary, now that we have, a full complement. It would be the timing when the new person's ready, the office is ready to start. Caroline's redeeming holidays for us to see if that seems, feasible. This is, again, Chief Ducharme's amount for contracted services, and I'm asking him what to put a revenue cut, because if this is just salary payout, the revenue should be more than 75.
Sure, yeah.
So I'm waiting for that. Payroll taxes, retirement. Life and disability, we pulled out in its up in personnel. That's why it's just a, so no change in the rest of this budget. So, but, this decrease is false because of the pulled out help. All right, we haven't heard from Chief Rutherford, so all I've done is a 2% ATD for the chief stipend and the salaries.
Right.
Everything else is the same. Building stuff. So Tom has recommended, based on his workload,
yep,
and the fact that he's health inspector, 6 hours per week.
Okay.
I did the math and it was really expensive.
Right.
So I had to check with him.
Yep.
And I said, Tom, let's do 5.
Okay.
Okay. You'll watch his workload. If it's too much, it's helpful to take priorities. What do you want him to do?
Right.
So this
has. That's what I was wanting to do anyway.
So this is final. It's increased. All right, and it says here with payroll taxes.
And the offsetting revenue goes for
the building
for the
building. Right. That he clearly
and the sewer out of the subject cap too, right?
Well, we have to
once we draw that.
Yeah, we have to try to do that. So road agent, this is the new salary. I don't know whether we are afford to talk about whether that's just that's it for the year. If we want to do something at the end of probation, I'm happy to be here at 52. Now, this is a full-time assistant, which was apparently recommended, not apparently, it was recommended by the search committee. So I costed it out based on $15 an hour,
yep,
for 40 hours a week. I added $2,000 for overtime because he's just an hourly person, so if there is overtime, the person's going to get overtime.
Right.
So if he's also plowing, there may be overtime, so we have to think about that.
Plowing would come under the your helpline,
wouldn't it? Well, not if he's a, not if he's an employee of the town.
Okay.
He has. It doesn't make any difference what he's doing, but he's working more than 40 hours and getting overtime. So that's all. So we have to figure that out because if he's plowing, he would be getting $20 an hour.
Well, that's why I'm saying, wouldn't he
disability health, and they pulled out safety shoes, safety equipment, bag health, I think, because they're like a person. Maybe two of some of these other things, you have to think about it. Cell phone, I think, we've increased. Oh, yeah, that's because of, that's a related issue, we need to increase it, so. Equipment, we'll be reviewing all of this too, with, we got a fourth quarter, but right now, there's no change.
Right.
No change in uniforms, we might be decreasing, because we've got another person. Supplies, no change. Vehicle repair and maintenance, there's an increase of thousands. And I'm looking at the quarterly report.
Yep.
I pulled out a lot of the costs, the equipment costs, which is in the vehicle maintenance line.
Yeah.
All of them.
Okay.
I think I pulled out equipment and equipment.
Okay.
Because if a plow breaks, that doesn't mean that the truck isn't good for another year, you know what I mean?
Yes.
So if we're looking at repair and maintenance, to see what we're, what the actual operating health of the vehicle is, we need to keep this separate.
I'm sorry, where?
Equipment is here.
Yeah, oh, sorry, top five, yeah, that's a.
So, so for the time being, until we see quarter three, I've got an increase of a thousand there, and keeping the equipment line the same. Signs, no change.
Yeah.
Line striking, no change. Tree maintenance, I've reduced it to 5,000.
Yeah. Did we ever get?
No, there's still maybe chance, you know, we'll look at quarter three, and we'll look at the purchase order.
I have George work with the argument, is it here?
Yes, working tree.
Yeah.
So, there's still an opportunity for us to get some trees down this year.
Yeah.
If the operating budget accommodates it. Sand and gravel, no change. Street sweeping. This incorporates the, what we were paid for this year. No change to coal pass hut mix. Salt, so there's a decrease in salt price. There's a hope that, you know, if George and company go to this green snow growing certification, that maybe we can cut down our salt use.
Yeah.
So I've kept the budget the same. We don't know what we're going to end up with this year.
George had also mentioned different plowing techniques that they incorporate in Berwick, where he had the most recent experiment. That is slightly different than what we're having in Rollinsford.
Mm-hmm.
So there could be reduced salt use.
Yeah, we'll see. You know, we'll see what we think.
Just on technique, so.
Yeah, and what Jody thinks as well.
Yeah, of course.
Roadside mowing, the same as
what
we paid, what we paid this year.
Right.
So this year's contract is roughly about 4,500.
Right.
You know, the Mike who used to do it for us for this amount is stopped doing roadside mowing. He does other things, but not roadside mowing. This is our contract, and it's supposed to be this week, I think.
Monday, okay.
Yeah. Stormwater management, we'll have to review that. I don't have detail in my head about what we might need to do.
Right.
So I've got it at 5,000, but we'll see. Our notice of intent is due.
Yeah.
Catch basin cleaning, I've kept it the same. And here's the 75,000. You know, again, whether we've all taken there, whatever. There's, at the moment, there's 325,000. 75 here, 225 down with the warrant,
right,
and the supplement for the channel.
Right.
And I'm meeting with Chris Tuesday.
So we'll go down another one. Other stories.
Okay. Street lighting, the same. There is, we have some outstanding repair requests here, which could be about $2,500.
Okay.
We don't know when they're going to come do them, but apparently that is so much for repair.
Yeah.
So we may need to increase that. Attendance, there's no change because when I work the salary, it's 2% stays within that budget. So they're getting a 2%, but we don't have to increase that.
Okay. Even with the additional
haven't done that.
Or do you, if we could buy some?
We have to work that out.
Okay.
We haven't done it, I don't know.
Right, okay.
Maybe we'll change our mind, maybe we won't do it.
Okay.
But that's a good point, let me make some of that, thank you. So, you know, health and safety, I'm just using the same as somebody, we have a new guy, we might have to increase supplies, they're working with the free supply.
Well, you have one with clinic.
Yes.
Not everyone is taking advantage of the uniforms, if I'm understanding. So, Jody has mentioned that we could reduce, maybe I'm just imagining, I think she didn't say that, I thought she did, that we could reduce that line potentially.
You check with Carolyn.
We've got to review on that anyway, so.
Yeah, we'll check with Carolyn.
Which I mean, we should review also, just to see how it went this year. I mean, I know for what we've been told, anyway, that, what's your regulations for the project, we have to give an option of doing it. But, you know, there's only one or two people that want, maybe we can, reduce, so. Maybe not, maybe that's just the standard.
I don't know.
Low level we could have, I don't know.
At this point, we'll take a look at what we've spent, for the number of weeks, and figure it out. Supplies, same, telephone, same, Rainbury Regional, so. This, well, there's a dollar and 50 tipping fees. And I increased the tonnage from 650 to 700, because, you know, the house is coming on board.
Right.
Hauling is, this is done. Yeah, just by calculating, and people have more information, and we're gonna get a little clearer picture than how to look at this hopefully. Trucking and recycling, we haven't spent that, we kept thinking, well, what if there's a change in price, so I took the liberty of putting it down 500. No change to equipment, compact service, and, disposal of metal tires, so no change in any of the rest.
We have to review it anyway, the disposal metal tire and all that, so make sure that the disposal fees aren't on our end, aren't going up. So that's what's charged, But just be off same revenue for some.
On our side, if we're paying, well, we should charge more. All right, this is the same, this is Bob's recommendations for the emergency management line, which have, already members, which have recommended. No change to the, well, except I, the $510 that was here.
Yep.
I used to fund the building inspector line.
Right.
Conceptually, anyway.
Right.
This is still for Bob's recommendation.
Okay.
So, yep. General assistance, no change. Parks and Rec, we're waiting for their budget, so I just rounded their $10,000. Kept the fireworks and kept Winter Rec. I don't know what we spent.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll include that in their budget if we're really lucky. It will be a comprehensive budget.
All right.
Library, I'm making a change, I'll have to see.
Right.
So, it's a 6.3% increase in other thing, you know, that again, it's something for conversation. If, not recommending, this is just a thought.
Right.
If we get like a sort of oopier trunk that could do some plowing.
Right.
You can use somebody that doesn't have a commercial license.
Right.
And kind of people who are coming forward, who don't have commercial licenses.
Right.
So I'll just say, I don't know why I think about that, I'm just offering that as a conversation.
Right.
And then I just put $100,000 as CIT related stuff, so cruiser, the furnace, the boiler, whatever is highway department, and the roof, you get here with the highway department.
Right. So the service truck, and the way that was pitched to the CIT committee, was this was going to be a truck to run parts to offset using a very expensive piece of equipment that uses a lot more gas. So we were envisioning a very small vehicle without all the bells and whistles that the town was
revolving into. I think you and I both.
I was chagrined when I came up with something different at town meeting.
Oh, I was more than chagrined.
So yes, but and I still feel that way. I wanted to have this little thing, but it also.
I thought it was fine, you know, just to.
But you know, Mark.
To run parts.
I mean,
I get that.
Here's the ugly truth.
I get that the state bid for a smaller vehicle would have been that, and that's fine. But it's now Frankenstein or something else.
Yeah, and we may not want to have anything to do with it, but just to come back, you know, my thought was used for two. Why? But what did you use from online?
Yeah.
They were more expensive than the state contract.
Right, no, I get, I understand.
So anyway, that's just a point.
But I wasn't starting from foolishly perhaps. I wasn't starting from the F-150 Silverado level. I was actually, I can't remember the model name now.
Well, it was the
lower level.
The 22,000. So it was 22. So whether we decide to do something, I don't think right now it's not there. It's not even in my little estimate of, you know, so it's a discussion point. Here's our financing. Again, this is not entirely clear. This is clear for the bond.
Yes, the debt service.
Yes, debt service, yes. It's this one. This is the USDA.
Okay.
I found out from bond council that we have a 30-year window, but they're counting the time that we took out the KSB loan.
Right.
So it may end up being 29 and a half. You know, I don't know what this is going to look like. So this could go up a little bit. Not substantially, unless it's a real change to the contract. No, we can't change the contract. We're matched. So yeah, so any overage on the project will have to fund from the operating budget. Right. So far, you know, you don't know what's over. But, you know, I'm listening to Paul Tanner, I'm listening to Parker, and it won't be substantial. And hopefully the operating budget, if there is something that the operating budget is accessible. So again, sort of placeholder-ish kind of stuff. I'm putting 90,000, which is safe, put 90,000 back into the CIP. I'm not doing the budget puts 90,000 back into the CIP, and nothing for town revale this year, and the standard 10,000 for the. So while it's total is a decrease, that's only because we have the million bucks last year. So we should get excited by that. That's why I give a big picture of the books. So we need to stop it there. I can tell you what revenue's showing. If you'd like to look at that.
double two parts.
And this is the one that's unknown. All right, revenue. So we sort of, you know, budgeting $10,000 from the land use change tax. That's the, comes from the warrant article.
Yeah.
So it's maybe more than $10,000 once we change the law. Resident taxes. I think we must have overestimated one year. Close to what it is.
Yeah.
Timber tax, some years we've got 19 years ago. And no idea what we'll have to do. No idea. We've never budgeted. For some taxes, it's pretty much a lot of what we get. It seems like a lot, but that's what we've been getting. It's important taxes. It's the flush efficiency permit, that's pretty much the same. I've increased water reading permits by 50,000.
Are we letting go?
No, thanks. Today on the list, tomorrow on the hips.
So. What happens to the revenue change here?
Okay.
Motor vehicle surcharge, I'm not really sure where it goes, but it is revenue left, so I put it there. Building permit. I've cut down, we may need to cut down more because we, you know, we're getting to the bottom of the end of the new homes at, right.
The timber.
So.
But there are.
There's always.
Other very large parcels of land, so.
And so far.
But I think it's, no, I think it's, no, I think that's realistic.
And the window that comes online, which could be a ways down the road still.
Yeah.
How does the town benefit? I mean, we benefit from resident taxes, vehicles, and those sorts of things. Well, did you set something up?
And he's been talking about wanting to get a restaurant in there. There's potential for more rooms and meals rather than it's minuscule though, but it's kind of a statement to come back to us. But
yeah, we only get it
at cost share. And there's a
we just get it at the block.
Right, at the end of the year, roughly, but it could be the more restaurants in the city, there's a potential for us to get more money. So,
Other license permits and fees, you can take a look at how I felt this, but no, the one that's the same. So right now I'm using the last DOE amounts which came out last December, or the milk and the higher.
Yep.
So Caroline says the state is behind in its calculations this year. So this, you know, hopefully this will go up, they'll both go up, and that would be.
I don't know how it works, how the budget was built.
We'll see. The railroad tax also calculated at the same time. Income from departments, you can take a look. It's increased, I think, largely because of the. Let's look at it now. So parks and rec. We'll see if they can bring 30,000. Zoning books, copying, are almost, fire department, not the, Okay, details. So here, I inflated it by 5,000, you know, I think 75, and I put an additional 5.
Yep.
Is that sufficient? Is it too much? I don't know, we'll have to see. Park the fines, pretty much the same. Actually down a little bit at this point. I'm sure we did bring it in. So false alarm, witness fees, down probably again because we're not getting any revenue shows.
So they didn't bring in the parking fine, that's the ticket issue.
Well.
It's certainly not violated in the village alone.
All right. Well, we take that for the restitution. Animal violation, transfer station tickets, would this go up if we tried to blow our?
Yeah.
Well, that is, yes, it's, yeah, but I guess. Well, we double it.
If you all did that, then that people would. You know, if you all.
I understand. Cardboard, pardon?
It's not double.
Cardboard recycling, food cans, scrap metal, transfer station fees, those are very good fees that we get. And demo, I don't know exactly what the distinction, but.
Also, when you bring the refrigerator.
Yeah, they come right here.
Yeah, that one.
And then that one. So that's the total, so that's what we see here.
Yeah.
And if you want to see the details from license, from the fees, and stuff like that.
If you want to go ahead, watch, you might as much, it's pretty much the same. So, pistol permits. Talking about all of that, that may go away. You don't need a concealed carry permit anymore.
All right.
And I don't remember if he still has, any chief actually, so have the authority to issue them. I can't remember if that was still written in the law that, you know, because of rest of prophecy between the states, so I don't know if this was mainly recognized or not, or Connecticut or whatever, I don't remember what states.
Yeah.
So, he may submit it to some, but there isn't a necessity to have one anymore, so that might definitely happen.
Okay, with this project, I don't know of any. It's just a cemetery lot, so I, at the moment, it's really that. Interest on investments, I'm not still inspirational.
Yes, they're getting inspirational.
Other.
What is other?
So, keep the franchise fee. Keep it the same pretty much, self on the same. I could say, checking in with them though.
Yeah.
See what they would, what they feel should. Rental property, that's what I'm doing, which I don't know, maybe about 1 year, so you can find that, if you want to.
When was the, I can't remember when the,
October.
Hey, no, yeah, but, so I have an issue there, but it could, tomorrow, you know, I can't tell, by the way.
No, it can be.
Right. When was the contract initiated in the first place?
You were not on the board.
I know.
So, it would have been 2013, since you came on the board.
Yeah, okay, so it's been a while, it's been quite a while. I'm not suggesting afterwards, wasn't sure what happened.
So now this is just an miscellaneous reimbursement, as you're, you just keep this line changed of the comparable one in the expense appropriation. This was a special, source from last year.
Yeah.
This is, FEMA Homeland Security from the,
yeah.
That sign, and here's that miscellaneous reimbursement line, so that's that other. Capital reserve funds, again, I've got 100,000, so, you know, it's transfer out, sort of thing. So, cemetery trust fund. We used to give this money every year, I don't know where they are, and they're trying to get things.
Oh, yeah.
Land conservation fund.
Must be.
Well, I don't know, they're still trying to whittle down, trying to get the principal all made whole. Grant, which is a zero grant, I'm not gonna get it.
Yes.
17, and we will get the 18. If the fund balance is 210, and the balance in the proceeds of financing, we won't get that. So that's where the revenue figure came here.
Right.
Leading us, frankly, very long to have a sort of projected 12-step line, but it's really goosey-goosey because we've got some unanswered questions that have been asked.
Right.
Few, not as many on revenue, but I didn't know, I couldn't remember the final figure for the evaluation. So that's kind of.
That's what you get.
Okay.
There you go.
Our daughter, thank you very much.
And,
Thank you for bringing this.
Represents quite a few hours of your time.
Do you have any comments, any other ones we need to go on the diet?
No, I'm good.
Okay. You can best think about, you have some things to think about. And, I guess we're good.
All right.
And, okay, I just want to just take.
Mike, watch your eyes.